حي على الفلاح.
We cannot compare creation to Allah. We can't try to imagine a throne of one of the kings now and think that's what the throne of Allah looks like. But what is the throne of Allah? Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned regarding the description of the throne of Allah that it is a seat or some place that you sit upon which has legs and it is carried by the angels. And the throne of Allah, it is like the ceiling, the dome upon all of creation. Meaning you have all of the heavens and the earth and everything which Allah has created. The highest thing on top of all of these things that Allah created is the throne. And then of course we know that Allah is above all of that. From the created things that Allah has created, the throne is the greatest from them. And there is a hadith in Al-Bukhari, the hadith of Abu Hurairah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that in paradise there are 100 levels, that in between each level the distance is like the distance between the earth and the heavens. How big that distance is, that's the distance between each level from those 100 levels. So it is a vast distance between each level to the next level. Then above the highest paradise is the throne of Ar-Rahman. And he mentioned in this narration that from there the rivers of paradise they flow. Ibn Abbas, he mentioned in the tafsir regarding the ayah, وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, it encompasses all of the heavens and the earth. That is the kursi, what you may consider as the footstool, not the actual throne. And to understand that, then we come to a particular narration that explains the size of the throne. There is a hadith which mentions the hadith of Abu Dharr, that Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the kursi, the footstool, the place where you would put your feet on. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned regarding that, that by the one whom my soul is in his hand, the seven heavens and the seven earths compared to the footstool of Allah, like a band or a ring that is thrown into a desert. What's the size of the ring compared to the desert? Hardly anything. Then it mentions in the narration that the expansiveness or the size of the actual throne, that is just like the same example. So if now the kursi, the footstool, was the ring, then the desert would be the throne of Allah. That is the vastness and the greatness of the throne of Allah. So can you consider how great is the creation of Allah and the throne of Allah? That is the example given regarding the magnificence of the creation of Allah. The footstool itself is magnificent and huge compared to all of the seven heavens and the earth. The seven heavens and the earth are like a ring in a huge desert compared to the footstool. But then if you compare the footstool to the actual throne, then it's as if the footstool becomes a small ring in a huge desert. And that vastness of the desert is the example of the greatness of the actual throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the Quran, in many places, Allah described the throne as being magnificent and great. On top of that, it is mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah, in the revelations in various parts, that the throne of Allah has what you would term as legs. It is mentioned in the hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the people will fall unconscious on the day of judgment. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, I will be the first one who regains consciousness. This is in Bukhari and Muslim. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam regains awareness, then he says, all of a sudden already, Musa alayhi salam is there holding on to one of the legs of the throne of Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I don't know whether Musa alayhi salam regained awareness before me, or if he had already had the falling unconscious that occurred at Mount Tur when Musa alayhi salam was made to fall unconscious that time. Maybe that was sufficient, and so it did not occur to him this time. But the point being that the hadith mentions Musa alayhi salam will be holding on to one of the pillars of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that indicates that the throne has pillars, it has legs. Also, it is mentioned in the revelations that there are angels who carry the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that there will be 8, and those angels, it is mentioned how Allah has created them in a magnificent and great power and size, that if a bird was to fly from the ear to the shoulder of one of those angels that carry the throne, then it would take it 700 years to fly from the ear to the shoulder of that angel. What was the first creation that Allah created? Some of the scholars, they say it was the throne. And some of the scholars, they say that the first creation was not the throne, but actually it was the pen. And told the pen to write. The pen said, what shall I write? That write down everything which will occur up until the day of judgment. So some of the scholars say, therefore the pen was the first thing Allah created. But some scholars say, it was the throne. What evidence do they use? They use the hadith of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhumah, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote down the decree of everything before the creation of the heavens and the earth by 50,000 years. And the hadith says, and his throne was upon the water at the time when the decree was written. So they say, when the decree was being written, i.e. when the pen was created and told to write the decree, and the decree was being written, this hadith says the throne was already there. So they say the throne was the first thing that was created. The throne of Allah is mentioned in the Quran many times. It's mentioned in the Quran 21 times. You now understand the magnificence and the size of the throne of Allah. You understand that there are pillars to the throne of Allah. You understand that it is the ceiling of all of the created affairs. One of the other points that should be mentioned is that when we talk about the throne of Allah, then just like the other things, we do not try to imagine how it looks like. We cannot imagine the details. We cannot try to describe the details. We haven't been given that. We do not know what the throne is made out of. So we cannot give descriptions of that nature, talking about what the throne is made out of or what it looks like in detail. We can't do that. We can't imagine that. But we do generally understand what a throne is. And we do have these descriptions about the pillars of the throne of Allah, and that it is a magnificent, great creation, bigger than the remainder of the creation. But we don't try to imagine in our mind what it looks like. On top of that, we do not incorrectly understand from this topic that Allah is in need of the throne. That is impossible. Allah is not in need of anything in his creation. The throne is in need of Allah. All of creation is in need of Allah. Allah is not in need of us. Even all of the worship that you do, Allah is not in need of our worship. Allah said in a hadith Qudsi, that if all of you, from the very beginning of the humans to the end, to the day of judgment, every single human and every single jinn, if all of you were upon the most pious heart, worshipped Allah and was upon obedience and piety, it wouldn't increase the kingdom of Allah. Allah's not in need of our worship. And at the same time, Allah mentions, if every single one of you, humans and jinn, were upon the most evil way, then that wouldn't decrease or take away anything from what Allah has. So no matter what obedience you do, what sin you do, it doesn't increase or decrease the kingdom of Allah. So Allah is not in need of His creation. And the throne is one of the creations of Allah. So that should not be incorrectly perceived. Some of the people of innovation, they claimed that there is no throne. All of these ayats that talk about the arsh, that they are all talking about some other item. They are not talking about an actual throne. They say it refers to the creation of Allah as a whole. It refers to other things. It doesn't actually mean a throne. But then the scholars, they refuted that. One of them being the hadith of Musa alayhi salam holding on to one of the pillars of the throne of Allah. If it wasn't an actual throne, then how was Musa alayhi salam holding on to one of the pillars of the throne? If it's not an actual throne, then how do the angels carry it? So no doubt it's an actual throne. And it is not correct that the people of innovation say that it is not an actual throne.